gentlemen, the energy expert, Julie Riche.
According to a Life at Work study done by the Harvard Business Review, 74% of employees are experiencing an energy crisis. So what does that mean to your organization? Well, that means that 3 out of 4 employees are actually falling asleep in meetings and being in a brain fog and hopefully not operating on heavy machinery. That 3 out of 4 people are actually stopping themselves from sharing their genius and opinions for fear of conflict and fear of bullying that might occur. That 3 out of 4 people are high on caffeine and sugary foods in order to keep up with the day. And that 3 out of 4 people are distracted, making mistakes, and wasting time that is costly to your operational budget. We hear and see that organizations are dealing with disengaged employees, low morale, low productivity, low performance, absenteeism, unnecessary conflict, lack of innovation, a reality that our organizations need to face. But imagine having an executive team meeting together and feeling energized and accomplished and on point to do what they set their minds to. And imagine seeing employees going out for walks and eating healthy lunches so they can be vibrant and attentive all day long. And imagine yourself in front of your computer and finally seeing a positive outcome of your HR analytics. My name is Julie Riche from Peak Energy Management. And my job is to activate resilience, well-being, and peak performance in your organization. See, I spent 22 years working in the government, and I saw what energy crisis was all about. Overwhelmed by all the emails in your inbox and not even knowing where to start. Working through your breaks and lunches and even bringing work back to your house. Witnessing toxic conversations happening at the water cooler, of management bashing and college bashing. And getting home so exhausted that all you want to do is crash in front of the TV. In fact, after working 18 consecutive days, overwhelmed with work and being a mom, I crashed. And it took everything for me to get up from my bed and move to my couch because I felt like an 18-wheeler had run over my body. And I laid on my couch for about 6 days. And between sleeping, sobbing, and experiencing intense physical pain, in my waking moments, all I could think of is, how am I going to keep going? How am I going to keep going? And on the 7th day, I woke up, sat at the edge of my couch, and stood up and told myself, Julie, in order to deal with all that's going on in your life, you need to learn to manage your energy. And so I dived into human behavior studies and found out how the people were able to function at their best, physically, mentally, emotionally, and at their core, and I applied everything to my personal and professional life. And I got excited for seeing my own transformation, and so I was sharing my knowledge and my experiences to my friends and colleagues. And all of a sudden, I was being invited to speak at team meetings. Invited to speak at the Staff Development Day, and being requested to speak at wellness conferences. And people would come to me after my presentation and go, oh my goodness, Julie, I can so relate to your life experiences. Oh my God, that scenario you use for Tired Tina, that is so me. And then someone would come and see me after the session, secretly telling me, you know that Debbie Downer scenario you shared? That's me, and I really need to change. So I knew I was onto something. And so it became my mission and purpose to develop energy management solutions. See, it's not about time management. It's about energy management. By a show of hands, how many of you have taken a time management course? Yeah, all of you. How many of you have taken an energy management course? Nobody. Why? Because nobody knows about it. And so if you think about being the most skilled and competent person on the planet, if you didn't eat right, And if you didn't have a good night's sleep, and you have conflict with your boss day in, day out, you are not going to perform at your best. And you could be the most tired and exhausted person in the workplace, and we will give you twice the amount of time to accomplish your tasks. It doesn't remove the fact that you're still going to be tired and exhausted. Smart companies today are shifting their focus from time management to energy management. And so imagine having twice the energy that you have, all the things that you would accomplish, the energy you would have when you get home after a long day's work, and all the deadlines that you meet, and feeling happy and proud of the work that you do in your workplace. So let's talk about energy. If you think about a car needs about one source of energy to get from point A to point B, and that is fuel. In humans, however, we need to access four separate energy sources in order to be at our best. The first energy source is the physical energy source and has everything to do with how you treat your physical body in order to have the quantity of energy to accomplish all that's on your plate. So we're talking about how well do you sleep? What foods do you put in your body and how frequently do you do that? Do you hydrate? And do you take the time to rest and renew to be at your best? The second energy source is the mental energy source. We're talking about focus, we're talking about productivity and mindfulness. And are you using those strategic habits to be highly efficient at work? The third energy source is the emotional energy source. And we all know that the better you feel, the better you will perform. So what is the quality of your energy in your workplace? And how are your relationships? Are they draining the energy out of you, or are they fueling you to be the best person? And the fourth energy source is the core energy source. And it has everything to do with your priorities, your values, who you are at your core, and how aligned are you to your organization's missions and visions? See, at Peak Energy Management, we offer strategies and also training programs to help individuals, leaders, and their teams really get into the energy of being your best self at the workplace. So contact me for a complimentary workplace energy assessment, and I will give you a score of how you are managing your workplace energy so that you know exactly how to peak it. Remember, invest in your employees, and they will take care of your business. And how about we reduce that 74% of people living in energy crisis and bring back the human into human resources? Thank you.